Jones' log. We battled for hours and eventually escaped the alien attacker, but they continued to give chase. We sought refuge in an asteroid field. Unfortunately, a rogue rock damaged the ship and set us adrift. Still hunted, we must find a way to repair the ship, all the while dodging any asteroids that may come our way. Our hope is that we may finally escape this hostile alien threat.
Episode 2, Adrift, is the first expansion for The Captain is Dead. Because it is an expansion, you will need to have The Captain is Dead in order to play it. Let's take a look at what's new in Episode 2. First, we expand the battle plan deck with some new abilities. And speaking of abilities, we add an all-new deck called the Veteran Abilities deck. This deck provides special abilities that you can add to any character in the game. There are 14 in all, and they're very powerful. For example, the Psi-Engineer ability allows you to use science and engineering cards interchangeably. The main feature of Adrift is an all-new mission. That means an all-new alert deck. In this deck, you're no longer battling an alien ship. Instead, they're sending probes into the asteroid field to try and find you. If two or more probes attach to the ship, game over. The new alert deck is also loaded with asteroids hurtling toward the ship. Asteroids cannot be overridden like original alerts. Instead, you must dodge them. Your ability to dodge is dependent on the current level of the jump core. In this way, the difficulty setting has an even greater impact on the difficulty of the game. There are also new damage tokens in the game that allow for micro damage to the systems. Alert cards will add damage tokens to systems. If you ever have to add a third damage token to a system, you'll remove all the damage tokens and knock that system offline. Aliens aren't transporting onto the ship, they're already here. You start the game by adding a hostile alien to every location on the ship. It can feel a little overwhelming. Aliens aren't just the roadblocks they used to be. Now they're saboteurs. At the start of any turn in which an alien is in a location with a damaged system, it will add an extra damage token to that system. Now that you know what's new, let's pick our characters, set up the game, and play the first round. For my first character, I choose the first officer, and I'm randomly dealt the veteran ability, Flash, which gives him one extra action each turn. For my second character, I'll choose the teleporter chief. He gets the veteran ability, Pack Rat. This allows him to start the game with a tool of his choice, and I'm going to choose the pistol. Also, tools won't count toward his hand size, so he can still carry 6 skill cards. For my third character, I'm going to choose the Scholar, and her veteran ability is Psi-Engineer, which will allow us to interchangeably use science and engineering cards. With our character choices out of the way and the game board set up, let's do the initial damage to the ship. As usual, we'll resolve the first 5 alerts to set the initial damage of the ship. We start by taking the first card, sliding one down, and drawing a new card, because the external scanners are still online. It's an alien probe. If we get another one of these, we're done. Now it's time to draw our second card. This time we'll add a damage token to the torpedo tube, discard a torpedo, and all players in the armory will be injured. First we add that damage token, then we discard a torpedo, but luckily no one is in the armory to be injured, so we can just discard the card. Now it's time to draw our third card. This time we reduce the shields by 10% and the teleporter is going to go offline. Slide the status bar down by 10% and flip over the teleporter system card. Now we can discard this alert. Now we can draw our fourth card. Unfortunately, this time we have to reduce the shields by 20% and we're going to add another damage token to any system that has one. We'll move the status bar down 2 more spots and the torpedo tube is the only one with a damage token, so we'll place it there. Now we can discard that alert and draw our fifth and final setup alert. It's an anomaly. The panels have started oozing slime. Anyone that uses a system adds a damage token to that system. Because it's an anomaly, that's going to remain in play. Now it's time for the first officer to take his first turn. Unfortunately, his first turn is interrupted by this alien that's in the armory. The alien is going to sabotage the torpedo tube, adding a third damage token, which knocks it offline. Now the first officer is ready to play. Fearing more damage, he's going to kick some alien butt. Then he'll move to the hallway and do the same. For his last action, he'll move to the armory. But due to Flash, he has one action remaining, so he's going to take revenge on the alien that knocked the torpedo offline. Now we have to resolve his alert card. Add a damage token to internal sensors, reduce the shields by 10% and the computers are offline. Discard the skill deck. We'll add a damage token to the internal sensors. Then we'll move the status bar on the shields down one position. Finally, we'll flip over the system card for the computers and discard the skill deck. Now it's time for the teleporter chief to take his turn. Unfortunately, his turn is also interrupted by a hostile alien saboteur. This time, the saboteur is adding a damage token to the internal sensors. For his first action, the teleporter chief is going to kill the hostile alien in engineering. He notices that the teleporter is offline and that it costs one action and two engineering to repair it. He's going to use his second action, his engineering discount, and his engineering card to repair the teleporter. All that's left for this action is to discard the engineering card he just used. Now that the teleporter is online, he's going to use his special ability as a free action to teleport to the science lab. Unfortunately, using a system means he has to add a damage token to that system. Now he's going to use his pistol as a free action to kill the alien in the science lab. Using the pistol requires it to flip to its B side. He's going to use his free teleport ability one more time and go to the bridge. Unfortunately, oozing slime adds one more damage token to the teleporter. Now he'll use his pistol a second time to kill the alien on the bridge. Now the pistol's out of ammunition and he has to discard it. He'll use his third action to move two spaces to the computer core, and his fourth and final action to kill the alien that sabotaged the internal sensors. All that's left for his turn is to resolve his alert. We're going to add a damage token to the internal sensors, computers are going to go offline, and all players in the computer core will be injured. We should have paid better attention to the external scanners. We'll add that damage token to the internal sensors, and unfortunately, that's going to knock it offline, which requires us to discard the attached skills. The computers are already offline, so there's nothing to do there. Unfortunately, we'll take our injury. All that's left is to discard this alert. Now it's time for the Scholar. She's going to get rid of that pesky oozing slime by spending one action and four science. She'll use her science discount and her Psi Engineer ability to convert her engineering cards into science. Now she can discard her engineering cards and that anomaly. Without the slime gumming up the works, she'll use her second action to use the comm system to give her command card to the first officer. Because she doesn't have any remaining skill cards, her special ability allows her to draw one now. Unfortunately, with the computers offline, she can't draw a card. She'll use her third action to move into the hallway, and her fourth and final action to kill that alien. Now we just need to resolve her alert card. For this alert, we need to remove a random unresearched upgrade from the game, and all players in the science lab are injured. We'll pick up the upgrades. Without looking, we'll shuffle them and choose one to discard. Oh no, it's epinephrine ventilation! We can place the remaining upgrades back in their position. Luckily, we just moved out of the science lab, so we won't have to suffer an injury. And we can discard this alert. Hopefully, that gives you a good idea of what it's like to play Episode 2, Adrift, for The Captain Is Dead. For more information, go to thecaptainisdead.com.